You might have heard how nice it is to use the bank feeds feature in QuickBooks Desktop and QuickBooks Online. But what are bank feeds? What does that mean? Bank feeds are when your bank takes the transactions that it recorded in your bank account and your credit card account and downloads them through the internet to your QuickBooks file. Now you may well ask, why use bank feeds? Well, the bank is already recording all of your transactions. Why should you have to record them too? Just copy the transactions from the bank into QuickBooks, and that would save you time. But wait! The bank doesn't know what category of expense each check is. The bank doesn't know what income category each deposit is, and the bank certainly doesn't know which customer or vendor was involved in each of your transactions. And the biggest concern is that banks make mistakes. So, how does it work? Well, first, the transactions download into a review list and do not affect your financial records. The review list allows you to add the expense or the income account as you go through the transactions one by one. The review list allows you to add the vendor or customer as you go through the transactions one by one. Now, the review list allows you to reject the transaction completely if it is a mistake by the bank. So this helps you catch false charges as they happen. Now, for every concern someone has about using bank feeds, there's a solution. You may duplicate a transaction because you're recording the transactions in QuickBooks at the same time the bank is recording it in their records. However, sometimes instead of adding from the review list, you can match from the review list to an existing transaction. This will help prevent duplicate transactions if both you and the bank are recording the same transactions. The bank could incorrectly add a transaction, but you can remove a transaction from the review list without entering it into QuickBooks. You may accidentally accept a bank charge that's wrong, but you can move the transaction back to the review list if you accidentally accepted it into QuickBooks and you should not have. So for any concern you have, there's a solution, and as you watch the videos, you will see this is a very helpful tool. Sometimes you have to edit a transaction after adding it from the bank feeds. One example of this is tracking expenses by job. This is also called job costing. But every once in a while, you might have to enter it from the review list and then find it in the way that you prefer to find recently entered transactions and edit it for additional detail. WebConnect files are going to help you when you're using your bank feeds. Because these are files that import directly into your review center from the bank feeds. These are files that are made available by your financial institution, and there are several different kinds of WebConnect files, and that basically means they have different file extensions. The great thing about using WebConnect files is that if you accidentally erase anything from your review list, you can import them again with WebConnect files. Bank feeds do not replace the need to do bank reconciliation. You could have accidentally added a transaction instead of matching it, and that's a common mistake when doing bank feeds. You could have matched the transaction in the review list to the wrong one in QuickBooks. So you might think that you're reviewing the transactions as they come in and you don't have to bother doing bank reconciliation. But just the act of reviewing the transactions through bank feeds could open up the door for these two mistakes that the bank reconciliation process will catch. There are many other ways to transfer transactions to and from QuickBooks Online and QuickBooks Desktop. And I have included all of the ways that I know, additional to bank feeds, in this entire course and all the videos of this playlist. I think you should watch all of them thoroughly. At some point, at least one of them will be important for you to know. I thank you for your attention, and good luck with the rest of the course.